YouTube, what's poppin'? It is your girl, Dope Ass Panna, and I know some of you guys clicked on this video fast as shit because you guys have been asking me for this tutorial, and I'm finally here giving it to you guys. I'm gonna show you guys how I got my Senegalese twist, and it took so much for me to post this video, guys, because I am super insecure about my twist, but recently I have been practicing and I have got a lot better, so I feel like it's time for me to share my techniques with you guys. The only product that I'm using in this video is the Shine and Jam, and I'm using it to both define my parts and I'm also using it to twist. And whenever I do my twist, I do prefer to do free parts, so that's what I'm going to be doing today. I just think it lays a lot more naturally and it looks a lot more natural than when I do foxes. So I start off by parting her hair in half, and then I'm gonna go ahead and attach the synthetic hair. And to do that, I'm grabbing both her natural hair and the synthetic hair, and I'm twisting them together. And you wanna make sure you twist it at least 2 to 3 times until you can noticeably see that it's tight. And the left side does not need to be twisted just yet. Next, I'm gonna grab onto the left side and I'm gonna pull it underneath the right side. And once again, I have not twisted it yet. And I'm freezing the frame here just so you guys can see my grip. This is super important because anytime I twist, I'm gonna be holding in this grip. And this is how I get my twist to be nice, tight, and neat. Once I pull the left side under, then that's when I'm gonna actually twist that side. So I'm gonna take her natural hair and the synthetic hair, I'm gonna twist it about 2 to 3 times, and I'm just loosening the grip between my thumb and my pointer finger so that I'm able to twist it. Then, once again, I'm gonna switch them, so I'm gonna pull the left side under, and then it's now on the right side. As I'm doing my twist, I do take product from the back of my hand, so I'm using Shine and Jam just to make sure that her hair is blending and to make it easier. Okay, once I do that, I'm just gonna continue to switch each side back and forth. And as I'm doing that, I'm kind of twisting the sides as I'm going. So you'll see me grabbing it here and twisting it. That's how I make sure it's tight. And then I'm gonna switch sides. Remember, every time I switch, I go back to that important grip, holding one side in between those 3 fingers. And that's how I make sure that the twist is nice and tight. I'm gonna keep the rest of this clip here in slow motion just so you guys can kind of see what I'm doing a couple more times. But I'm just making sure that as I'm doing the twist, I'm also twisting the hair. And I think that's a mistake that a lot of people make. You can't just grab the 2 strands and twist them. You have to make sure you're twisting the strands as you're switching over and doing the actual twist. And I think that that is the tricky part for some people. I do like to use product when I'm doing these because twists honestly hurt my hands, which is why, number one, I hate to do them. And I just find that it's a lot harder for me as a braider. So using the product kind of helps it be a little more smooth, but you totally don't have to use product. I know there's people that are against it. I'll show you guys how I attach it in another clip, and then I'll go on to show you guys how I do the ends.
Mm-hmm.
ends of the hair, I'm gonna be twisting all the way down until I have about an inch or less worth of hair. And obviously you wanna measure out the hair before you do the twist to make sure that you are achieving the length that the client wants. And once I get to the bottom, I am gonna be burning the ends of the twist, but I'm not gonna be burning it all the way off. I'm kind of just burning it to secure it to make sure that it doesn't unravel. And then once I'm done, I will dip them all together. So you see here, I'm twisting down as far as I can go. I'm just gonna take the lighter and I'm gonna lightly burn it and just kind of pinch it. And that's gonna make sure that my twists don't loosen up as I let it go. So you can see there, I kind of just pinched it. So it's nice and closed. The twist will not unravel, but I'm not burning it completely off. You can if that's the look that your client is going for, but that's not the look that we were going for in this video. A good way to know if you're twisting correctly or tight enough is that as you are doing your twist, you should honestly be able to let your twist go and it doesn't unravel. And that was one way that I knew that I was twisting properly and twisting it tight enough. That's kind of like a good test. You'll see if I let it go there, my twist does not unravel. If it unravels, then you're not doing this correctly. You need to try to go back and do it again because maybe you're possibly twisting too loose, or you're not twisting the strands as you're doing the twist. And I know that sounds like super confusing, but I mean, that's kind of how you can explain what you're doing. You're twisting the strands as you're completing the twist. Once I have completed all my twists, I go in and I kind of clean them up with scissors, and I'm just making sure that I am cutting off any flyaway hairs off of the bottom of the twist. And this happens a lot when the hair starts to thin out. You'll notice that some pieces start sticking out, so I'm just going through and kind of cleaning them up. Sometimes I see people do these with box braids also. My box braids are usually fairly neat, so I don't really need to do this, but twists, I do find that like this does help me clean them up a lot, especially at the bottom. Next, I'm going in with everybody's favorite step, and I'm adding mousse onto her hair. And I'll be sure to link the mousse that I use in the description section. I know a lot of you guys like to know what brand, and I use the Vigoral Styling Mousse. It is linked in the description section for you guys. And this just helps to lay down any flyaway hairs at the top. And it's also really, really soothing to the client. I know all my clients are like, oh my God, yes, it feels so good. So for the last step, I'm gonna be dipping the twist in hot water, and that's just to finish off the look of the ends. Remember, we burned the ends, but I did leave out about an inch of synthetic hair, so I'm gonna go ahead and dip that just to straighten it out and to make it not as puffy. And you will notice that the twist loosened up just a little bit wherever it was dipped at, but it doesn't unravel because we did burn the ends, and it doesn't really take away from the look at all. And that's pretty much it. And guys, this here is my finished look. I hope you guys really enjoyed this tutorial. Like I said, my twists are not perfect, but I am working on perfecting them. And every time I do them, they get better. And the same will happen for you guys if you guys keep practicing. Remember, practice makes perfect. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this tutorial. I know a lot of you guys wanted to see it, so here it is finally. And if you guys loved it, make sure you guys share it with everybody you know. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I have new videos coming weekly for you guys, and I have some super awesome content on the way. And I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye. Guess who back in the house? Heels click clacking about. Fine, fresh, feminine style to 11. I'm divine, so heavenly. Gentlemen sweating, it's down across the board, no doubt. Body like wow.